friends, welcome back to my channel, Kara ASMR. I feel like Tisha Paytas at the moment because I'm on my living room floor. At least it's not my kitchen, right? So, anyways, today's video is going to be a very simple, just sit down, relax, mukbang, Q&A type of video. So, I am using my Blue Yeti, but I'm not doing ear to ear just because I want to try out other features on the mic that I haven't got to yet. This is the omnidirectional portion of the mic. So I'm seeing how it picks up the sound from just one side. So if it doesn't sound good, I also have my backup mic on my camera. So I have two different sounds going in right now. So we're good. But without further ado, I think we're gonna go ahead and get on to the video. Because I went to McDonald's and I got some food. And I haven't eaten today for the purpose of this video. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and get the food out first. First things first. Light ice. The ice is already melted, but it helps not make the drink water down. So. Then I got the, I think it was number 5, I think it was what the number was. I haven't had one of these in so long, but I'm so ready for it. Admire the bag there for a second. I don't eat McDonald's as often as I used to. For the longest, I did a year without McDonald's because of some teacher I had. Some professor told me he did it, and he told me he didn't think I could, so I did it just to slide in. And then I went back to it. So. Of course, we have. So this is the artisan grilled chicken. I don't know if you guys have had this, but it's like heavenly, and I haven't had it in so long. I'm so ready for it. The setup's so nice. You can see the food and you can see him. I don't know how he does it. I can't do it. Because, like, I feel like I'm hunched over and also on my nephew's play table, though, so. There's these, I don't know if you guys have seen them. My nephew got one in his Happy Meal. They have these versions, and they're like super tiny, and they're so cute. So, yeah, don't call me a psychopath, but I'm liking the grease on these. There's always grease on these fries, and I don't like the grease. I don't do it to pizza, but I'll do it to fries. Okay. Jefferson grilled chicken sandwich. Number 5, I think. On the other night. But it's so good. It's not the grilled chicken sandwich, the crispy chicken. It's the artisan grilled. So, I'm gonna go ahead and take it out and sit it there. It's not greasy at all. The bun looks, it makes it look like it would be shiny and greasy. But that's just the way the bun looks. It's golden brown. It's not greasy. Not greasy at all. So I'm going to. I have ketchup here, but I actually think since I do have barbecue sauce, I'm just going to eat my fries with this. So yeah, I'll do this. I know I do all the time. So when I have fries, it's not ketchup. Usually, it's only ketchup for a last resort. Staring off over there because my microphone is hooked up to my computer. This one is. Keep wanting to make sure it's picking up everything. It is currently 2:35 p.m. Oh my God, I used to work at a radio station. So let me just give you my radio voice. Okay. Well, good afternoon, people. But that's not what I said. Never mind. I'm gonna quit. I would say the citizens' names. Like, what town I was progressing in, but... Like, Like, good morning, Riverdale. It is currently 2:35 p.m. on a beautiful Friday afternoon. Today you can expect lots of sun and lots of jams as I'm coming at you in the next hour with hits from the great Lady Gaga. It's been a long time since I worked at the radio. I've definitely lost my touch. Okay, so I'm gonna answer some questions. Emma Swartzen, I hope I'm saying that right. I'll have all the comments here at the bottom of the screen. Do you know any other languages? I'm learning French. So, I commend you on learning French because I tried to learn French. I used to have a friend who lived in France. We don't speak anymore. But I tried to learn French for him and I cannot. I used to know Spanish, a lot of Spanish. ¿Cómo estás? Soy cara. Why do I roll my R's? I always roll my R's. Soy cara. Cara. That's about it. I can read it better than I can speak it. I always feel so impolite when I chew my mouth open because I don't normally do that in real life, but I have to for ASMR. I guess it's no different than like an actress playing a douchey role in a movie. Like, they're not like that in real life, but you gotta do what you gotta do, and this gives ASMR sounds, so. Thank you, Emma, for your question. Chris Nelson asks, do you put up your Christmas tree and Christmas lights before or after Thanksgiving? My family usually puts them up after Thanksgiving. Just because we're usually so swamped during the period after Halloween, before Thanksgiving, with getting everything ready for dinners and stuff like that. So, because I have a pretty, well, not super large, but kind of large family. So it's a lot of preparing. My brother, though, him and his wife, put their tree up this year on Halloween. Which I thought was hilarious. Okay. Thank you, Chris. Jade asks, what sort of music are you into? What are your favorite songs and artists of all time? My music taste changes quite a bit. I'm gonna be honest with you. I guess I'm sort of into a lot of independent artists, but like without meaning to. Like it's not like one of those, oh, it's indie, and like, no, it's like I don't mean to. But those are the bands I like. Like they have a soft, mellow kind of vibe to them. The Milk Carton Kids, I love them. Paramore, it's not really indie, but I know probably all their songs by heart, so that's probably one of my favorite artists of all time. One of my favorite bands is Paramore. I'm trying to think. I do like you know, regular music too. Like, I'm not like one of those weird people. I really love, this is gonna be really crazy because a lot of you guys probably don't know this, I really love G-Eazy, the rapper. Are not for kids, but they're really fun to listen to nonetheless. I really enjoy them. It's great to just dance. Lizzo, love Lizzo. Do my hair toss, fix my nails, yeah. Like that's also, I think probably Juice is my favorite pirate. Juice or Boys, probably. Because of the rhythm of it, like bouncing kind of rhythm, I love that. And she's a fellow flautist, hello. So yeah, my music taste varies. I don't care much for country. I do like Dan and Shay. Just putting that out there. Like, that's the one country artist I like. That's new. Old country I'll listen to. Like Loretta Lynn, Dolly Parton, Pam Tillis, Tanya Tucker, George Jones, Willie Nelson, people like that. So, when country was good. No offense. Okay. Thank you, Jade. So I'm going to finally take a bite of this sandwich because I've been dying to eat it. Okay. That is a sandwich. That is a sandwich. So good. Ryan asks, have you ever been in a relationship? For how long? Was the person male or female? I'm trying to remember what my last relationship was. It's been that long. I've dated both men and women, so, yeah. I guess I consider myself straight, so I'll date men, but I'm not like a stranger to it, you know? So. My last relationship, though, I think was 7 months, I want to say. 7 or 8 months. I'm so glad. He was really sweet, but we were just on two different levels, I guess, of what we wanted in life. So it was a mutual parting. Honestly, she's probably one of the best relationships I had, because it was like an introduction into, you know, what life has in store in relationships. So, yeah. Thank you, Ryan. Okay, so Gianna asks, I hope I'm saying that correctly. Do you have any celeb crushes?
I'm glad you ask.
No, I have many celeb crushes. I always told myself, it's funny when people ask me, my friends ask, that I have a hall pass on each side. So, on the guy side, I have Tom Holland. We all know this. I have a phone case. I have a Pop Funko. Multiple Pop Funkos. I'm obsessed. It's kind of unhealthy. Female side, I have Natalie Portman. Natalie Portman is one of the most amazing actresses I've seen on screen. I hadn't cried in a movie since Perks of Being a Wallflower. And then I saw Jackie. Cried my eyes out for probably 3 hours after the film was over. So it was really good. But I mean, Tom Holland, we all just know I love him. So I will give you a fun fact, though. I used to write embarrassing fan fiction about Tom. So, when I was a little younger, I still write like fan fiction, like on an archive of our own and stuff. You're not gonna find me, it's a different name. It's a pen name, but yeah, that's a fun fact about me. I still write fan fiction to this day. It's just a fun way that when you're writing a novel, to kind of blow off some steam and write something else for a while to get those gears turning again. So yeah, it's really fun. Plus, I used to write that for a living. Like, I used to be paid to write fan fiction, and it's really stupid, but I used to. For people online, so yeah, why not just do it for fun as well, you know? So, Gianna also asks, and what's your ideal relationship? By the way, I love your channel. Oh, thank you. My ideal relationship is a balance of many things. Most importantly, a relationship I feel is trust. I mean, you have to trust your partner enough to know that if they don't text you, that they're not off screwing someone or off like cheating on you, you know? You know, they have their own lives. I'm really bad at texting, I'm really bad at answering DMs, we all know this. I'm terrible at this. I hardly ever look at my phone anymore. I don't know why. I'm mostly just like reading and writing and focusing on stuff like that.
And the videos that are coming in December. But I think that's a big thing is trust. A balance of keeping things exciting too. This does not mean anything sexual. Don't take it that way. But I feel that a relationship can get very stale and boring when you're going to the same places constantly. Like, let's go to the movies, or let's go to the same place, the same restaurant, over and over. Spice it up. Have some fun. Spontaneously go to the amusement park or something. I don't know. I went with my ex to... A long time ago, I went to Cannon Park in West Virginia. And that was really fun. It was exciting. It was switching things up a little bit. So you just have to make things, you know, I guess... new. So, and trust as well. So, and you know, a bunch of other things. You know, you have to love, you have to you know, accept the person's flaws, you know, things like that. So learn to talk things out. To me, that's a perfect relationship. Someone who's gonna listen and explain instead of jumping to conclusions. Okay, so Naomi's life is really sweet. She wrote a bunch of questions. So the first one is, how did you first realize you enjoyed ASMR and wanted to be an ASMR artist? It's a very good question. And when I think about it, I'm gonna get ketchup. No seal on it. I'm so damn keto. There we go. That's better. I think. Okay, so I've told the story before about how I first discovered ASMR. It was through a friend who showed me a video. I watched it, and at first I thought it was going to be like really weird and gross and stuff, but it actually turned out to be really relaxing. And then when I started watching more and more, I thought, hey, if these people are giving some kind of service, making people feel good through these videos, why can't I do that, you know? So, turned on my phone. I think I was using my headphones at the time for a microphone. And I uploaded a video. I kept uploading. And then at one point I uploaded one certain video that you've probably all seen. A lot of people that are coming in started watching, and I was like, well, I'm actually reaching people, so I thought my videos were just being watched by me. Like, that was insane. So, yeah. And I'm so grateful for all of you every single day, because this channel gives me a purpose, you know? So... what's your favorite song at the moment? This isn't the same person. My favorite song at the moment is either Lover by Taylor Swift, not the remix. I don't like Shawn Mendes. Not really, I'm Trisha starting drama on the floor. No, but I like Lover. It's just the melody of the guitar, it's so pretty. I'm trying to learn it on ukulele, but it's so difficult to play. Either in that or Probably Truth Hurts by Lizzo. I've been listening to that quite a bit. When it comes on the radio in the car, I just like blast it, and everyone in the car is just like, oh my god, I can't help it, I gotta dance. My car's swerving all over the road, but I'm having fun, you know? Do not attempt at home. We've all been there though, when our favorite song comes on the radio. Oops. It's a bad hair day, so I'm wearing a hat. What pets do you have? I have two. No. Four pets to count. So I have. Well, they're not all mine. Only one's mine. Two, technically. So I have a dog, Sahara. And then I have. My sister has a cat, Moki, who is the oldest thing. But I swear, she walks around like she's a newborn. So then there was TJ, which is my dad's cat, who literally just walked by. Holy crap. And then Milo, who was my grandmother's cat at one point. But then when she got really sick, she gave him to me and told me I needed to take care of him. So I have been. He's very old, though. Like, old and decrepit. But again, he still moves around like he's brand new. It's, I mean, these cats are healthy, so. Yeah. Thank you, Naomi, for the questions. So, I don't have much food left. So I have this list of unusual asks. I think they're on Tumblr, I found them from. So we're just gonna read a couple of these. A few of these out by when I finish eating, so. I'm not letting the sandwich go to waste. So the question is, what did you want to be when you were a kid? I wanted to be a doctor. And then a vet, and then a psychiatrist, and then a writer, and the writer part stuck. So, do you like your name? Why? Yeah, I chose it, so I like it. I don't know what else to say. How tall are you? So, I am actually very tall. I'm 6'1", believe it or not. Yeah, I'm pretty tall. Which is kind of weird to see, like, a 6'1", towering woman, you know? But, I'll never forget, I was... I was giving a poetry reading. At my old school, and I was in heels because we had to dress formally. I was sitting there thinking, oh god, I'm so tall, and I was talking to one of my friends about it, and I was telling her, god, I had to wear these, because I feel like I'm, like, super gigantic and tall. And one of the girl's moms, who was at the reading, came up to me, and she said, you embrace what you have. And I was like, what? And she said, what you don't like, you flaunt it even more. So yeah, if you're 6'1", make yourself 6'4". You know? So... yeah, I'm kind of at peace with my height. It makes it easier to be independent, I guess. I can raise the top shelf. That's one thing about it. But I have to have certain vehicles, which is another thing that's bad about it. Because I can't fit into certain vehicles because my legs are so long. What is your guilty pleasure? Girl. You don't even want to know. No, I'm just kidding. Maybe. school bus. I think my guilty pleasure, I have two. So one is writing fan fiction, obviously. Oh my god, I'm so crazy. The other is reading a lot of unnecessary erotica. My therapist says it's healthy, so it's fine. As long as it's not unhealthy, I'm at peace with it. And I really enjoy that. If you have read anything by Kendall Ryan, pick up a Kendall Ryan book. She writes beautifully, so. I like the books that aren't just sex in your face, you know? So. What was your Halloween costume this year? Ooh, I posted this on Twitter. I was Mickey Mouse, because my nephews really love Mickey. So I was Mickey, my mother was Minnie, and my brother was supposed to be Goofy. But we didn't have enough time to get the costume ready, because it was, we thought we had the hat, but we couldn't find it. What is your opinion on the Kardashians? These are really unusual questions indeed. Kardashians. Sue me. I watch them a lot. Probably not healthily. Like, it's probably too much of an addiction. Maybe that's not a guilty pleasure. I really love the Kardashians. I think they're really stupid. And, they, like, script a lot of things, obviously. But they're business empires. Women, like, you can't deny that. They have built an empire. Kris Jenner has built an empire off of a sex tape. Let's be honest. Like, come on. I'm gonna get flagged for saying that word twice in this video. Anyways. Opinion on cigarettes. I don't smoke, so I can't say much. No one in my immediate family smokes, so I'm not gonna comment. I don't like it though. I have asthma. My mother has a lung condition that prevents her from breathing properly, so I don't like it because I just, yeah, I mean, like, it's hard when your lungs don't work and you don't have a choice about it, but other people do, and they still choose to do that. So anyway, enough about that. Do you want children? Absolutely. I think I do. Yeah, absolutely. How many though? I'm not sure. In my head, I have the perfect ideal suburban life of, like, wife, husband, girl, and boy for kids. But it don't work that way. So. And so, I think we'll end the last question with favorite social media. Instagram, I have to be nice. And on Twitter, I can show my depressed self if you've all been there. I saw this meme that said, I forgot you can't make death jokes and stuff like that outside of Twitter. And this guy said he was in his office. And one of his coworkers is like, are you ready for the week to be over? And he said, I'm ready for my life to be over. And the guy's like, dude, are you okay? It's a joke, and I forgot I can't make those outside of Twitter. Relatable. So, that was all the food. That was really good. That was breakfast and lunch for me. Probably dinner too. It was a lot. So,
thank you so much for watching. Thank you all for the questions that were sent in. This was really fun. It was just nice to sit down and relax, enjoy yourselves. So yeah, hope you enjoyed. Till next time, remember you're beautiful, you're wonderful, and you are loved. Bye.